Welcome to Edimo Tutorials. We are now discussing Unit 2. In the previous videos, I have discussed these topics: introduction, ellipse, parabola, and loop, cycloid, and helix. So if you've missed it out, please make sure to check out those videos. In this video, I will discuss how to construct a sine curve. So the definition of the sine curve and the introduction to it, I discussed in the introduction video, so you can make sure to check that out. Now let us discuss how to construct a sine curve. So let us take the question. Construct a sine curve generated by a circle. Take the circle diameter as 20 mm. So I'm going to take the diameter as 40 mm. As of now, I don't have a pro circle, so it's difficult for me to construct a circle with 20 mm. Like this. Now we have to divide this circle into 8 parts. So this 90 degrees, again 90 degrees, 30 degrees, 60 degrees, and again 30 degrees, 60 degrees. So I divided the circle into 12 equal parts. Now we'll just extend them. I'm sorry, before I said 8 equal parts, it's 12 equal parts. So we have to extend these lines. So I extended the lines and I marked these points as the angles. So this is 0 degrees. So from here to here it's 30 degrees. From here to here is 60 degrees, 90, 120, like that. So this full thing is 360. Sorry, this is 330, this will be 360, yeah. So now here, you can take any point, just little away from the circle, you have to mark the circumference. That is pi d, that is 3.14 into 40, that is 125.6 mm. So you have to mark that and divide that into this many number of parts. So here we divided it into 12 parts, so that circumference also we'll divide it into 12 equal parts. So I marked the circumference, now I'll divide it into equal parts. So I divided the circumference into 12 equal parts. So now I'm going to mark all these points as angles, that is 0, 30, 60, 90, etc. So I marked the points. Now we'll draw perpendiculars to these points, through these points, like this. Now, so 0 is 0, this point. 30 is passing, the line passing through 30 intersects 30 here, so this is going to be the point for 30. Similarly, 60, 90, 120, 150, 180, 210, 240, 270, 300, 330, 360. You have to mark those points. So, I'll show you how. So, for 0, this is the first point. For 30, so this is the line for 30, so this is the point. 60, this is the line for 60, so this is the point. 90, 90, 120, 150, 180, 180. Alright. So 210 is here, so 210, it's coming down. 240 is here, so 270, 300, 330, and finally 360. Now joining these points will give us a sine curve. Again, you can join these points using freehand or using French curves. So the curve will look like this. So some points to remember is, again, the markings here and these lines have to be little lighter than the sine curve itself. The sine curve has to be drawn with HB. Only for video purpose I have shown this much darker, and I have shown these markings with pen. You can also dimension the circle. So we have completed this question. So we have completed sine curve. Let us take a look at some other curves. So these are some other curves. I will not be discussing how to construct these in this video series. Because these are generally not asked in the exams, you can refer them in your textbook. If you want me to discuss these, please make sure to drop it in the comment section and your question will be addressed. But some other curves are trochoids, epicycloids, hypocycloids, epitrochoid, hypotrochoid, evolutes, like how we discuss involutes similarly, spirals and its types, etc. So there are many. So I discussed the main ones. That is these. I discussed ellipse, parabola, involute, cycloid, helix, and sine curve. So with that, we complete this unit 2 curves. Hope you got a clear idea on this unit. In the next video, we'll be starting unit 3, that is projection of points. So that is a very important chapter. That is this, unit 3. In the next video, I will be discussing introduction of this chapter. Thank you so much for watching.